So I have talked about many different books from multiple genres and countless authors on my channel. And there's one consistent thing I find myself either criticizing or heavily praising authors for. And what that is for me is the morality presented in their story and how their characters align along it. This might seem a little basic, but I want to get into a little bit deeper here why so many very talented authors seem to fail at making a believable, flushed out character, and not just assigning them a slot of a scale of 1 to 10 from good to bad. And I know not everyone's taste aligns with mine. There's nothing wrong with just liking a good or bad guy approach and moving on from there. It falls into a lot of classic fantasy, classic fiction in general, ideals, and I can suggest many books that do this very well. But me personally, I'm much more a fan of a gray protagonist, someone who is believable. Because I myself am not a good person in every aspect of my life. Neither are you. We are selfish. We are flawed. We're human. And still to this day, even in modern writing standards, authors still write people as if they just fall into a binary system. Just good, bad. Ignoring the fact that we are incredibly complex creatures with chemical reactions going off in our brains and countless connections and neurons and all these things that result in us being fairly unpredictable and strange. Now, the prime example of this, and one that actually does this more binary approach to morality very well, is Lord of the Rings. We have Sauron, who's evil because evil. We have the good guys, the hobbits, the pure, the nice, and a couple characters who are a little bit ahead of their time and were more gray. Boromir, for example, is a good gray character. But again, even his grayness was done a little bluntly. Compare that to what we see now more frequently, but still not all the time, in characters like Kaladin. People who really consider doing bad things. They walk a line. They suffer from realistic human emotions. But even with Kaladin, I have some problems with how quickly and how righteously he was able to turn around. That's why I actually am a bigger fan of Dalinar. Kaladin's considered doing some evil things. Dalinar has done them. Mild spoiler for Stormlight, though I'm not going to get more specific than that. This made me engage with Dalinar's character so much deeper. He's someone who has regrets, and regret is an incredibly powerful tool to make a reader connect with a character. Thinking back on something they wish they hadn't done, thinking back on something that haunts them, is something I wish I saw more often, and I'm just not seeing it on the level or the frequency that I feel it really should be utilized. And that's not the only reason a deeper morality can help your overall story. It can make your villains more nuanced if they have real motivations. Thanos, for example, is an incredible villain because we understand where he's coming from. We are all afraid of scarcity. It's a very real threat that faces our planet. And while his logic might be slightly flawed in how he approached it, it's still a cause that's based in a real fear. Thanos does not think of himself as evil. He thinks of himself as a zealot on a quest, and there is nothing inherently evil about that. If I was writing the movie, I would have taken it a little bit further and had Thanos explain that before he came along to use the stones to their full potential, none of these stones were actually being utilized to help anyone in any way. All of them were just being locked up or held as treasures. It would have been much more interesting to me to have him approach this with, look, no one has been using these tools to benefit everyone, so now I have to take it to the extreme to make up for lost time. You can also then just throw in a line about how the Reality Stone can't make things permanently, which they don't seem to do actually in the movie. Many people say, why didn't he create food? If you notice, everything he creates goes away or vanishes once he stops putting effort into it. That would have actually explained his character a little bit deeper, and I would have liked it. And I hope that makes you understand what I'm trying to go for here. I don't want my villains to be right, but I want them to think they are. I want a debate to be present for actually following them. Because then everyone who does follow them gets a little bit deeper, a little more relatable. It's a cascading effect throughout your story that makes the entire conflict that is central to people actually connecting and enjoying and being captured by your hooks all the better. Put some bait on those hooks. Now, you'll frequently hear about conflicted heroes, and this is something that, again, does not always rely on morality. Sometimes it's just pulling between two righteous causes. If you look, though, the greatest heroes in fiction and movies and books alike often are torn between the good and the bad that's around them, because the bad's actually kind of pulling in a realistic way. Whether it's something that's kind of magical, like Luke Skywalker in Star Wars, where the dark side is more power, it is a faster way to this power, and he uses it to beat Vader. That is a somewhat believable thing to tempt our hero. He needs that power to win and come out on top. But the example I'm going to use here most strongly is that of Rand Althor. Robert Jordan was the master of this kind of gray morality prevalent throughout The Wheel of Time, even though the setting of The Wheel of Time feels like it should be very black and white. We have the Dark One and the people who serve the light. But that didn't stop Robert Jordan from putting good and bad characteristics in people on all sides. Several of the Forsaken are charming people, and some of them have very real logic for why they joined the Dark One. And there are people who serve the light who are monsters. The White Cloaks are essentially the Spanish Inquisition of the Wheel of Time, people who believe they're serving the light but committing atrocities doing so. All of our main protagonists in Wheel of Time struggle with morality in this way, in a setting that is a dynamic world that is very tempting on all sides, but none as deeply as Rand. He's offered the easy way out. That is the most blunt temptation from the shadow. He could simply join and walk away from the light, therefore no longer having this responsibility on his shoulders. And don't worry, again, I'm not going to get much more specific than that. But later on throughout the Wheel of Time, many more tempting authors actually planned routes or ways for Rand to maybe kind of walk away from his full responsibilities are presented, and with the character that's built up, someone who's constantly feeling crushed, someone who is hurt, someone who is physically and emotionally abused throughout the Wheel of Time, it seems very believable that he could take one of these easier options. But if Robert Jordan hadn't taken the time to build on top of the basic binary foundation of good and evil he started with, the light and the dark, this kind of interest wouldn't have been there for Rand. He would have just been your typical good guy with a sword going against the big baddie. I really enjoy this nuance, but please don't take what I'm saying here as trashing the more traditional binary moral system. I don't have a problem with that. Samwise Gamgee is an incredibly engaging hero, and he is probably the most wholesome, pure hobbit that has ever hobbited. I love reading his story, and I love The Lord of the Rings. But when it comes to modern standards, I'm craving a bit more. A lot of series like Stormlight Archive, Gentleman Bastards, Game of Thrones definitely stick more to this gray system, and I enjoy that. But I want it to be more thorough. You still see the typical good guys within these series, and it just doesn't seem believable to me. I cannot relate to a character who's just motivated by, I want to be good. And it doesn't have to be shallow motivation. It doesn't have to be money, it doesn't have to be power, it could be a love, friendship, or something a bit more nuanced than even that. But just having someone saying, I'm a good person, therefore I will spend my life fighting this thing, I don't necessarily understand or relate to that. Make there be a lost loved one they're doing it for. Make there be friends, make there be stakes, a protection, a need that is just beyond who I am, therefore I must do. I hope that makes sense. But once again, I just want to push against the idea that I am saying just having a binary moral system is bad. I just don't find it as relatable as putting the time and effort in to make your villains and heroes more believable, more something that reflects what we could see in our real world. Anyway, guys, I hope you liked this video. I know it's a little different than what I typically do, having just a little bit of a rant in one specific topic, but this is gonna be a new thing I'm calling Dear Author, and this is me just addressing the authors out there. If anyone here is writing a book, please take the message home that I don't want your villains to just be mustache twirling bad anymore, and I don't want your heroes to be just muscle flexing good. I want there to be human motivation behind them. But that is just my opinion, and maybe some people agree, maybe quite a few people disagree. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like and subscribe if you have not already. Hit the Patreon if you want to support what I do here. And have a good one, y'all. Peace.